Okay, now we'll start with sewing. Okay. Now see, what is sowing? Sowing means to put the seeds in the field. Okay. Obviously, this is very very important process. Until and unless you put the seed inside the soil, what is going to grow? Okay. So what is sowing? To sow the seeds in the field is sowing. Okay. So what is sowing? To sow the seeds means sowing of seed. Okay. To put the seeds into the field is known as sowing. Now see, before the seeds are sown into the field, few points has to be kept into the mind, which are very very important. First of all is quality of the seed. Okay, quality of the seed. We'll be discussing in the last part of the chapter how the seed, better quality of seeds can be taken. Here, quality of seeds, how like the quality of seeds totally decides the quality of crops. Okay, so quality of seeds means what? How it should be? See, the seeds should be totally healthy. It should be free of all kind of infections. It can, okay, how to know about this? So you know, suppose if you take certain grams, or like I should say chana, okay, at your home, take few chana at your bowl of chana at your home and put water to that. Okay, you will find if the all the chana, all the gram seeds are of good quality, they will sink, they will be at the bottom. Okay, but if it is not of good quality, or if it is not in good condition, okay, then what will happen? Few, you will see that few seeds are floating on the surface of the water. Now why these seeds which are not good, they float on the surface of the water? Because see, when the seed is not good, so automatically it becomes vacant, it becomes empty from inside. Because see, if it is not good means what? It is infected, presence of some worms or something like that inside this. So what happens? The amount of seed, and the amount of part, the amount, the thing inside the seed becomes less, so it becomes lighter and it starts floating on the surface of the water. So this is also a very good method to know the condition of seed, whether the seed is healthy or it is not healthy. Okay, so first thing which has to be kept in the mind is what? Quality of the seed. The seed has to be very very good, then only the whole efforts will be of use, or else everything will be of just a waste of time, money and energy. Okay, the first thing is quality of seeds. The seed has to be free of infection, free of germs. Okay, it has to be of good quality. Now when I say it has to be of good quality means what? It has to has certain, like you know, part of nutrient. I'll just take one example. Now suppose there is plant A, okay, it is of tomato and it gives very good tomato. Okay, so when I say good tomato means what are the things which I talk about? I may talk about the color, which should be red. Okay, I may talk about the flesh, means it should be fleshy. I may talk about the size, that it should be big enough. Okay, and I may also talk about the taste. Okay, so I may also talk about the taste. So see, when I'm talking, I've just given an example of a tomato plant having a tomato. I just want to explain you the quality. What does it means when I talk, when I say that it has to be of good quality? So first of all, here also I should write, it should be having good resistance power. Okay, it should have good resistance power, or I can write strong resistance power. Okay, if everything is there, tomato is red colored, it is very fleshy, it is quite big, the taste is also very good. But the thing is that as soon as you cut the tomato, it is rotten, it is not good. So what is the use of all this thing? Okay, so if it is second example, if we take like it is having a good resistance part, but the color is not red, so it doesn't attract the person who is going to purchase. Okay, if it is not fleshy, it doesn't make any sense in taking the tomatoes which is not fleshy from inside. If you cut and there is no flesh inside it, even such kind of tomatoes we have in the market, like we can't understand from like by looking, like it's not good from inside. But as soon as you cut, you will find that nothing is there inside. It is just like empty sort of thing. Not totally empty, but not as fleshy. Now size, we'll never prefer to take very small, tiny tomatoes. Okay. Now taste, it should taste nice. Whatever taste nice means what? Whatever taste of tomato is there, it should come. So see, when I'm talking about a particular thing, tomato, I'm talking that it should having a good resistance part. That means when I cut a tomato, it should not be rotten from inside. It should be red also. It should be fleshy also. The size should also be big, and the taste should also be good. So this is the quality of the fruit. So how it is going to come? Obviously, whatever quality all these are coming from, this all comes or is possible only with the good quality of seed. Okay, it is possible with the good quality of seed. So in this case, when I will say that this is a good quality of seed, when I am getting these many things from the fruit, then I will say this, yeah, it is fulfilling all the things which I require. And so I will say, yeah, the plant is good, the fruit is good, and it's worth buying this, it's worth eating this, it has all the good thing in it. Okay. So first of all, the quality of seeds should be very, very good. I hope you all have understood what's the meaning of quality of seed. Should have strong resistance power. Like color is red means it should be having a proper color, whatever I'm talking about. If I take the example of gram, chana, it should be brown, it can't be black. Okay. So fleshy means it shouldn't be empty from inside. Whatever, like when I talk about rajma, say for example, it should not be empty from inside. Whatever has to be there, has to be there. Size, I won't prefer any time, or no one will prefer any time to take very small size of say rajma, very very small size of rice. Okay, so quality, like the size should be very good. Taste, we talk about the this thing, wheat. Okay, so many names are there which is very famous. Okay, like Sihori, Gyu and all this thing, Sharbati. So people come from a long distance from the other state to buy such kind of thing, to buy such healthy or just the seeds with the like the grain which is having the crops which we have with a good quality. Okay, so this is all about the quality of seeds. It should be very very good, healthy. Okay, so what? Free of infection, free from infection. Okay, now before sowing, again what has to be done? It has to be treated. The seeds has to be treated with fungicides okay, why? So that there should be no seed borne disease. Okay, to prevent seed borne. Like why it has to be treated? Matlab there should be no seed borne disease. That means a disease which is all with the seed is already having. If seed is already disease, that means what will happen? The crop, what we are going to get, will be diseased. Okay, so the seed should be free from infection. It should be treated from some fungicide so that we can prevent it from the seed borne disease. Okay, now seed should have good amount of water. Good amount of water. See, if the seed is totally dry, okay, so what will happen when we'll grow the seed? It doesn't has enough amount of water, and so the growth process will stop. Okay, the germination of seed won't take place. So even the seed should be having proper amount of nutrition in it to provide it to the seedling. Okay, now okay, so now we'll be discussing about the next thing, like what are the things which we have to keep in mind. Okay, now the next is, when sowing the seed, the distance has to be kept uniform. Okay, proper uniform distance should be there between the crops. Okay, means proper uniform distance should be there. See, now why there should be proper distance? If in a field, like all the seeds are at very little distance, so what will happen? Overcrowding will take place. That means at a particular place, more number of seed will germinate, and what will happen? A kind of a competition will be there in between the seeds to get proper nutrition from the soil, for water, okay, for the space even. So the proper growth of seed or the proper growth of the crops won't take place. Okay, so this is very very important that the proper and uniform means equal. It shouldn't be there that one is at one place and the second is at very far. Okay, so proper and uniform distance should be there between the I should not write crops over here, rather I should write the seeds. Okay, so the proper distance between the seeds should be there so that when the crops grow up, okay, so there should be no overcrowding. What will happen to prevent? To prevent overcrowding. Okay, so proper and uniform distance should be there between the seeds to prevent overcrowding. Now, what is the next one? The depth, okay, of the seeds should be proper, or I can say the seed should be sown at the good proper depth. Okay, means what? Say, when we are putting the seeds, when the seeds have been sown into the field, two things can happen. Like first of all, the seed are very deep. Okay, if the seeds are very deep, the fertility of the soil down will be less, and so what will happen? The seed won't be able to come up. Okay, that means it won't be converted, it won't get converted into a plant. Second thing, if it is very superficial, superficial means it is on the top layer only, it is just kept like that only and it is not covered by the soil, then what will happen? The birds will come up and eat the seeds. Okay, so seeds will be eaten away by the birds. So depth of the seed should be proper. Now overcrowding, okay, when we talk about overcrowding, what will happen? It will give rise to unhealthy, it will give rise to unhealthy competition. Okay, it will give rise to an unhealthy competition for what? Water, space and nutrition. Okay, and nutrition. What is the meaning of overcrowding? Too many plants at one place. What does it going to give it? Unhealthy competition for water, space and nutrition. Okay, now if the depth is not proper, then what can happen? Birds will eat away, okay, birds will eat away the seeds. Okay, and if it is very superficial, in which case, if it is superficial and if the depth is more, okay, then what will happen? Won't grow if sown at greater depth. Okay, so birds will eat away the seeds if it is superficial and won't grow if sown at greater depth. Okay, so these are the points which has to be kept in mind before the sowing. Okay, now first of all, just we'll have a quick revision of this, quick recap. Sowing, what we are studying now, sowing, to sow the seeds in the field is sowing. To put the seeds into the soil is sowing. It is very very important process. Until unless the seeds are there in the field, how the crop is going to come. Okay. Now, for this we need to keep certain points in our mind, like it should be free from infection, shouldn't have any kind of disease. Okay. Seeds has to be treated by the fungicide to prevent seed borne disease. Good amount of water should be there in the seed. Okay, should be there in seed. The seed is totally dried, then what will happen? It won't germinate, it won't get converted into a sapling. Now next is proper and uniform distance, which we have discussed a lot, and depth of the seed should be good. Okay, if it is like distance is not proper, what will happen? Overcrowding. What is the meaning of overcrowding? Too many seeds at one place, too many plants grows at one place. What will happen? It will give rise to a competition for what? Which kind of competition? To get water, to get nutrients and for the space even. Okay, and the growth won't be good. Now if when the seeds are sown, it has to be sown at a proper depth, not too much inside, not too much superficial. Okay, so this was about how the sowing has to be done and what is sowing. Now how the sowing can be done, again we'll talk about the ways, the methods. Okay, to start with, again I'll talk about some Hindi movies in which you have seen, a few songs are there, okay, in which you might have seen the farmers. I'm talking about the old movies. Okay, you might have seen that farmers are just spreading the thread seeds. Okay,